Mayfair. Could you tell me if I'm on the right road for Westport?
Sure.
Turn left here. Are you going my way? Would you care for a lift?
It's very kind of you. I thought of catching the bus at the crossroads.
You should have checked up on me before telling me the way like that. For all you know, I might be a German spy or something.
Good morning, sir.
I want to see the proprietor. I have a book here which I'm anxious to sell.
Just a moment, please. There is a gentleman outside, Mr. Barnett. He wants you to buy this book.
Oh, yeah. Yes, very interesting. Ask him to wait a moment, will you?
But it will not be long.
Thank you.
Yes, a most interesting book, sir. I think I've got a client who might like to buy it. Will you come inside? By the way, I don't know your name.
Davis. My papers are all in order. I understood I should get further instruction from you.
Yes, that's right. Sit down, will you? Oh, sit down.
Thank you. You're lucky. No thanks, no.
Here, go.
Thank you. That girl of yours, she isn't English?
No, she's a Dutch refugee. You see, Westport's always known me as an anti-Nazi. So is she, for that matter. She's a useful cover. If she should get to know anything, her parents are in Rotterdam. The Gestapo can always take them under its protection. Now to business. You'll go to Watercombe. It's a little place down the coast here. You stay at the White Hart Hotel. I've booked a room there for you.
In the name of Davis?
Yes. The 95th Brigade is expected in Watercombe in about 3 days' time. You will be comfortably settled in before they arrive.
If I want anything urgently, what shall I do?
You ring this number, Westport 77250. Ask for Ned. It'll be me. Talk about family affairs. What identity papers have you brought with you?
I have them here.
Ration book, identity card, driving license, passport. God, our people are thorough. Every detail, just as I sent it over. Yeah, you should be all right with those. It's the safest alibi we can find for you.
Have you a copy of my account?
Oh, how wonderful. I thought you did go back. Did you miss your train?
Couldn't have known I was coming. It didn't wait.
Oh, what will you do now?
Get the next one on the 3-day CB, I expect. I say, oughtn't you to...
She's reading Gone with the Wind. A chapter at a time.
Yeah, it's nice to be gone with the wind, too, if I don't want to miss the next one.
Write to me before you sail.
Of course.
And send me your address as soon as you get there.
You all that last night. Besides, you know, you people here aren't exactly outside the war zone.
I will write. You know I will.
the better.
Are you taking that book, madam?
Oh, whatever came over me? I don't want it at all.
Anything wrong, Miss Lehman?
A customer seemed to think our books were free.
They'll fetch quite high prices, don't they, Mr. Davis? Good day to you, sir.
Bye, Betty.
Goodbye.
Don't you know this is a prohibited area?
Is it? I'm so sorry. It doesn't say so. Still, I quite understand. I beg your pardon.
A hand, isn't it?
Reconnaissance.
Possibly. Well, they've chased him away anyhow.
That's odd.
I gather Jerry hasn't been in this part of the world for months. If they have any reason to suppose. Still, I hope I'm wrong.
I hope you are, sir.
How do you spell Jenkins, Johnny?
You ought to know that by now.
Thanks for nothing. Well, it's going to be a nice how-do-you-do, isn't it? When you've got to post your love letters in an army postbox. And a man got no private life these days.
Me to go and spend Sunday with him.
Oh, so he hasn't gone abroad after all?
No.
Oh, it's well timed. You needed something to cheer you up, didn't you?
Mm.
Number 23 reports that the troops exercising at Watercombe have rope-sole shoes, grappling irons, ladders, pulleys, and other tackle. Sounds like a cliff landing. There is no evidence of their having any new methods of exploding landmines.
Well, why the devil should they?
If they were planning a surprise raid, they would hardly wish to begin it by exploding mines. This is good, as far as it goes, but we must have more detail.
Number 16 has not yet reported to our chief agent at Westport or anywhere else. I'm afraid he may have been caught.
Then our agent at Westport must make other arrangements.
Very good, Excellency. We might also use the report of that woman at Watercombe.
Certainly.
There are signs that the enemy is becoming interested in Watercombe. That reconnaissance plane, for instance. I'm quite certain that didn't come over by accident. The Boche has got information about this place, and we've got to stop him getting any more. You've got to help me stop him. Remember, the enemy has highly trained agents. They may be in any walk of life. Grocers, pub keepers, barbers, politicians, people whom the enemy's bribed or blackmailed, even people who admire Nazism so much that they're ready to betray their own country for it. Watch out for these people, all the time.
Do you mean you want us to report everyone who asks us questions about what we're doing?
I do. I know we have professional security services functioning in this country, field security, police, and so on, and I think they're efficient. But they can do little without your help. You are the people who can stop the enemy getting that vital information that he wants. You are the real security men.
Anything new?
Yes, sir. There are one or two things. An officer's lost a map.
Yes.
And there are three more cases of flashing lights.
There always are. Better investigate them.
Yes, sir. Oh, and three soldiers came in. They said that last night a man at the White Hart asked some questions about the embarkation exercises.
Good for them. What was his name?
Calls himself Davis, sir.
Mr. Davis, yes, we have. A very nice gentleman. He's been bombed out.
Has he been here very long?
Oh, about a week, I should think. Why? Is anything wrong?
No, but I wonder if you'd mind pointing him out to me.
Oh, very well. He's in the coffee room, I think, having tea.
I wonder if you can manage it without him seeing me.
Oh, very well. Come up this way. There he is.
Thanks. Good God.
That's not Mr. Davis.
No, I know. Thank you very much.
What, can he have some gas masks and things?
Oh, they've laid on a whole heap of new gadgets.
Excuse me. Can I speak to you for a moment?
Oh, yes, sir.
I shan't keep him safe.
What's that girl doing here?
Well, she's perfectly all right, sir.
Yes, but what's she doing here?
She's playing at Westport.
She's staying in the hotel?
No, she just happened to come over for the afternoon.
Very odd.
Yes, sir. Well, as a matter of fact, she may... Well, I rather believe I did just mention Watercombe, sir, when we were at Newby, but she's perfectly all right, sir.
Staying here for dinner with you?
Yes, does that upset you?
I'm delighted.
Hello. Is that Westport, 7713? I want to speak to Chief Inspector Jolly, please.
Who's there?
Police.
What do you want?
Are you Miss Clare's dresser?
Yes, I am. Who are you?
Inspector Jolly, Special Branch, Westport. A lot of luggage for a striptease act, hasn't she? Give me the keys. What's in these?
Oh, I don't know. Never seen them in my life before. I don't know everything she travels about with her. To cover her blasted business.
Direct hit, eh?
No, thanks.
Go on.
Oh, thanks.
You must have had a narrow escape.
I did indeed. Only just getting over it.
Well, you'll find it nice and quiet here. What made you think of water come?
Oh, I don't know. I used to come up here for my holidays as a boy, you know.
You lived in Newport long?
Not Newport. Cardiff.
No.
You want her on the phone, sir?
I think of it.
Hello, Richard's here.
Yes, Charlie.
You have, good.
You found what? My God. Yes, I know where she is. All right, you leave that to me. Yes. Yes, all right. Straight away, straight away.
It took a hell of a lot of fixing. And they've given me the most awful place in the program. Shut me right in after the interval with everybody in the bar. Still, Tommy, darling, it's worthwhile being together again. Oh, look who's back. Your little friend seems very busy, doesn't he? What is he, a military policeman or something?
Well, I think he thinks he is.
And to top it all, they've given me blue limes for my finale. They won't see a single thing out front.
Excuse me, miss. With Mrs. Taylor's company, will you please spare a moment with her in the office?
Well, what the hell?
Perhaps I'd better come too.
No, Tommy dear, you stay there. Order me another drink. Keep it cool till I come back.
Is that you, Ned? I got your letter about Aunt Mary. So sorry she's not well. I'd like to come and see her.
Why you should send that girl to Watercombe when I'm there?
I didn't send her. She doesn't work in this area.
Well, she was there today, and she's been arrested. So they know for certain now that we're working on the 95th Brigade. They're already getting suspicious. Their security man sounded me this afternoon.
So that's it? Afraid of your own skin?
Don't be a fool. My value there is gone once they suspect me, you know that.
At Watercombe, yes. As it happens, you can be more useful elsewhere. We've lost number 16. You will replace him.
What was he working on?
Ordnance depot. Job. I don't know if it's quite what you're expecting.
I'm down on my luck.
Take this to the employment exchange. They'll give you a pass to get you into the depot. Report tomorrow morning at 8. Next, please.
New one, you mate?
Yes. Big place, isn't it?
Yeah. I reckon they got enough explosives here to supply the old ruddy army.
Any accidents?
Not yet. But they will have sooner or later with all these ruddy women about. There you are, what did I tell you?
I wouldn't if I were you, mate. She won't thank you. What a burp.
Can I lend you a hand?
I can manage, thanks. I'm perfectly competent to do this job myself.
Bad luck. Just when you were starting out.
Damn careless, these men about here.
sprinkle nails around like bird seed.
That'll be all right.
I shall never catch up with the others now, and I'll get hell from the sergeant. What do you do round here?
I'm a hod carrier.
Hod what?
I'm a hod. I'm helping to build a shelter.
Oh.
Right, will you get the spare? Thank you.
You're welcome. Have you always been a... I mean, you don't talk a bit like a... whatever it is you are.
I suppose I don't. I had a little business of my own. It was bombed. I lost all my savings in it.
Thanks.
That's all right.
Have what?
Oh, thanks very much. Oh, is that all right here?
Oh, yes, the explosive shed right down there.
Thank you.
Thanks. I say. Why don't you come to our dance tonight?
I didn't know there was one.
Yes, it's in the gymnasium, the ATS weekly dance. This'll get you in. I'll look out for you.
Thank you.
Going to the dance.
Hey. Not that way.
Oh. Thanks.
Jolly glad you were able to come. It's a bit of a squash, isn't it? But the band's marvellous. And do you know Sergeant Ramsbottom? I've forgotten what your name is.
Davis.
Well, come on, let's go and have something, shall we?
What do you have?
No, these are on me. I'm hostess here.
Beer, then, please.
The same here.
Two beers and a shandy, please. You know, I'm simply whacked. We drove all the way there and back with only half an hour's break.
Where did you go?
Just outside Westport.
No, giving away secrets.
I'm not doing anything of the kind. Oh, there's Sergeant Hayhurst. She left her flapjack in our mess. We'll have the next one, shall we?
Hawkins, yeah? Hmm. A cigarette? Thanks.
What's your job?
I'm working for the builders.
Oh, lucky man.
Why?
Well, you keep regular hours, don't you? I do 12-hour shifts, and even then I'm lucky to get off.
You must be very busy here.
Busy? Do you realize that we have to maintain 150,000 vehicles from this place, and they all think their requirements are urgent? To give you one example, we've got two divisions going overseas next week. On top of that, I get a request for a whole lot of special equipment from the 95th Brigade. Immediate, that is. Now, I ask you, what could be more immediate than sending two divisions overseas? But, oh, no. I tell you, I shall end this war in a padded cell. I've got a date for this one. So long.